Hello everyone, we are Group A. Our topic is the problem of malnutrition in Indonesia. Our presentation is divided into three parts, introduction, four approaches, and conclusion. Malnutrition is a problem that people all over the world need to solve together. Our group will focus on the problem of malnutrition in Indonesia. Through a survey of Indonesia, we believe that the problem of malnutrition in Indonesia is based on the four upsides. Gender, economy, culture, and policy. Because of the economical and cultural factors, Indonesia cannot solve the problem of child malnutrition on its own. Therefore, it also closely related to the process of world globalization and measures taken by international organization. Therefore, in a humanitarian spirit, can from the point of view of world economic development, we believe that the solution of this problem also requires the assistance and international cooperation of other countries. First of all, we find that in Indonesia, women are forced to become pregnant at a very young age. This is due to sexism. In Indonesia, women also so underprivileged that they are expected to conceive and puberty, but it's actually against the laws of physiological. Adolescence is a critical period for the growth of every adolescent girl. During this period, their development is not perfect and they do not reach the condition of healthy reproduction. In addition, due to the relative background, Islamic and widespread sexism in Indonesia, girls who are already in their adolescence will suffer from malnutrition due to insufficient food intake. So teenagers, girls who become pregnant during puberty are born with Indonesia. The lack of breast milk from women after birth can lead to babies not being fully breasted at birth, thus exacerbating malnutrition. Gender is commonly used as variable for culturing significant difference between men and women in epidemiological studies. However, gender has greater potential to address health issues if this variable is used within theoretical framework. According to research on widening or reducing the gender inequality involved in malnutrition in the same family, we can find that children do better in families where women are charged and can exercise their rights. So when women are given more power, it also reduces the incidence of malnutrition. Malnutrition and sexism are two of the biggest problems Indonesia needs to solve. Only by taking the idea of gender equality into the heart of people can gender equality be achieved in existence, thus addressing malnutrition and promoting development in Indonesia.
I will use the economic approach to analyze this topic. The poverty is often mentioned as the root cause of malnutrition. The poor economic conditions in Indonesia prevent children from living a clean environment. For example, the significant causes of malnutrition are unimproved latrines and untreated drinking water, which cannot be improved because of poverty. The health of local residents, especially children, have been influenced directly, for their immune systems and other body conditions are more vulnerable than adults. We can see in this picture, there are 25% children died before 5 years old in Indonesia. So, the World Bank cooperates with Indonesia government, introduced a series of solutions and public welfare projects aiming to solve standing problem. For sanitation and drinking water, the Indonesia government have launched a project called PANSMAS. This project is aimed to increase the number of underserved rural and peri urban populations accessing sustainable water supply and sanitation service. These are the data I found on the official website of the World Bank. We can see that most of funds in this project are used for water supply and sanitation, which responds to the problem I mentioned before. This project also gets a lot of international help. In this other picture, we can see that many relevant organizations offer their help. In the pessimist website, I find this data, and I'm looking forward to see this target KPI will be achieved this year. The positive response measures taken by the Indonesia government have achieved some results and also have received support and help from the international community. As Honorable Mr. Trishing Wendy from Bhutan's Ministry of Finance said, Indonesia calls improving nutrition as a national priority among others by adequately investing in the nutrition of children. In the short run, it is worthwhile expenditure, recognizing its many long-term beneficiaries. Such recognition triggers other countries to emulate their best practice. We also believe that the better sanitation and the water quality will enhance the immunity of local children and have a direct impact on reducing children malnutrition.
In the third part, I want to analyze the child malnutrition in Indonesia from a cultural perspective. First of all, most families in Indonesia do not have the correct knowledge of breastfeeding. They have not received systematic training courses on breastfeeding and infant feeding before giving birth. The lack of knowledge leads them to use the wrong methods in infant feeding. For example, they do not breastfeed in the early stage of infancy, but let the infant eat formula milk or other foods. This has a very bad effect on the baby's development. Secondly, the whole society has a vague understanding of the nutritional value of food. They do not have the correct concept of diet and nutritional balance. In poor families, children are most raised by their grandparents. The elder reject the theories of nutritional balance and insist on using traditional feeding methods. In families with good economic conditions, because parents are busy with work, they prefer to provide children with fast food. This wrong dietary concept have led to the occurrence of child malnutrition. In response to this problem, various organizations and government have carried out a variety of projects to solve it. Indonesia have launched a national communication campaign, which aims to use multiple means to provide effective public and dissemination of correct nutritional concept. First, the government train volunteers to enter the community. These volunteers provide face-to-face teaching and guidance to every family. Second, use the mass media to strengthen the science of correct nutrition knowledge. They buy aids on Facebook or YouTube to place courses on correct breastfeeding and infant feeding. Since the launch of this project, families throughout Indonesia have had many more ways to learn correct nutritional knowledge and gradually realize the importance of a balanced diet. Since 2009, the NNCC has served 40 million people. Judging from results achieved so far, the method is effective in solving the problem of child malnutrition. This method of using the media to expand the scope of information dissemination to dispersed populations is of reference significance for countries with spread territory and dispersed populations like Indonesia to solve the problem of children malnutrition.
Now let's see through the political approach. The malnutrition problem in Indonesia are mainly caused by the political unrest and many levels of government. Actually, Indonesia have a quite low of political stability. The political stability can be calculated by statistics, and in this scale provided by the global economy, the lowest is from negative 2.5, which means the government is very, very, very weak. To the 2.5, which means the government is very, very strong. It has a very strong political stability. And in the case of Indonesia, the average value for Indonesia during the period from 1996 to the 2019 was negative 1.05, with a minimum of negative 2.09 to a maximum of negative 0.37. So Indonesia have quite low political stability. To make this more clearly, in the 195 countries that are calculated, Indonesia was ranking in 137. So with low political stability, it means women and children's health conditions cannot be ensured. Another reason is that Indonesia is a highly decentralized country, and it has many levels of government since it is a country built on nearly 6,000 of islands. So the policy made by the central government can be very hard to reach to the village governments and other local governments. So although the order is being reaching out to those lower governments, it is hard to ensure their practice. So the Indonesia government have cooperated with the World Bank, and to solve this problem, they provide funding, and those funding are directly to the village and communities for them to dig well for more clear water. So those grants are direct to communities and reaching 24 million households across the 600 islands. So as for the evaluation, the Minister of Finance in Indonesia, she evaluates this cooperation like, the budget management is critical, whether it is the budget of the central government, the district government, or the village government. So Howard actually points out that the problem is caused mainly by the levels of government, and the actions of using those funds and grants directly to the village and communities can be a good answer to this problem. So for the conclusion of our analysis, in general, Indonesia's efforts to reduce child malnutrition are meaningful and worthy of learning from other regions.